Hello everyone, it's morning, it's not even noon yet, and I'm awake, and this is very exciting for me because I spent probably a year and a half where I couldn't get up before 2 o'clock in the morning without a major life crisis happening or something. So I'm very excited to be awake and bright-eyed and bushy ponytailed, literally bushy-tailed. So what I wanted to talk about today is limitations. I have a lot of areas I could talk about limitations. I could talk about my physical limitations, which is pretty boring because I have a disease called ankylosing spondylitis, and it makes my vertebrae grow together and pinch nerves and stuff, and it's ugly. I'll have a link to it if you want to learn about it, and I'll probably talk more about it, but let's set that aside. I had to have a surgery to fuse from my fourth vertebrae to my seventh vertebrae. And when that happens, they go in, you think that your back and your spine is all back here, but it's really not. It's actually easier to get in through the front, and when they do that, they move some things. And so you end up with a sore throat afterwards, and sometimes, in my case, I had what's called vocal cord paralysis, which is exactly what it sounds like. Your vocal cords don't work, and you literally lose your voice. You can tell in my speaking voice that my voice has dropped, I'm raspy. You know what, I don't care about my speaking voice. I'm glad that I'm able to talk to you and that you can understand me. That's really important to me. But for 2 months after I had my surgery, things progressed. I was very tired and, you know, normal surgery recovery, but for 2 months I couldn't really talk. And I think the worst is that my son was very young, and when I would go to pick him up at school after band practice, imagine, like, you know, 212-year-olds being released at the same time, and of course they're excited and they're, you know, calling to each other and such, and I would reach deep down and try to yell to my son, and all that would come out was this walk. It was very, very frustrating. I never did regain my full range, and a lot of you know that I sang through high school, through choir, or through college. I sang a cappella in college. I sing in my car all the time. Singing is very important to me. Music is very important to my life. And I sang in my ukulele ensemble, and I really, really enjoy a good harmony. Man, do I enjoy a good harmony. Which comes to the problem when I come to a song that I want to play and that I want to sing, and I used to have the range for it and I don't anymore, and it's so frustrating for me. Now there's this book that you might know that's called The Wrinkle in Time by Madeleine L’Engle, and most of us are introduced to it around third or fourth grade or older, because any adult can pick it up and get just as much out of it as any third grader or fourth grader, because it's an amazing, amazing book. I was actually gifted it by my babysitter for my 9th birthday, and thank God, because if I was not introduced to her, I don't know what my life would be like. In A Wrinkle in Time, there's this conversation between the characters of Calvin O'Keefe and Mrs. What's-It. And I'm gonna read the quote because it's very important to me, to my life, to anywhere that I am limited, because I'm so frustrated when I hear the words, "You are not limited. There are no limits. Everybody has limits. And you can say it all you want. Everybody has limits somewhere. And it's what we do with those limits that's important." So Mrs. What's-It starts off by saying, "In your language, you have a form of poetry called a sonnet. It is a very strict form of poetry, is it not? There are 14 lines, I believe, all in iambic pentameter. That's a very strict rhythm or meter, yes? And each line has to end with a rigid rhyme pattern, and if the poet does not do it exactly this way, it is not a sonnet, is it? No. But within this strict form, the poet has complete freedom to say whatever he wants, doesn't he? Yes. Calvin nodded again. So? Said Mrs. What's-it. So what? Oh, do not be stupid, boy, Mrs. What's-it scolded. You know perfectly well what I am driving at. You mean you're comparing our lives to a sonnet, a strict form, but with freedom within it? Yes, Mrs. What's-it said, you're given the form, but you have to write the sonnet yourself. So, when I'm looking at these songs, this is what it comes down to. I have my choices. One is scrap it. I can't do it. I can't. It's out of my range. Keep trying. Someday maybe I will be able to hit that note and then I will be able to sing that song for you. But some of these notes, some of these ranges, I've been working on my range for years. The surgery happened in 2014. That's 6 years this month that I had that So 6 years. For about five of them, five and a half, I have been working on getting my range back. I'm not gonna let life go on and just not sing the song because I can't hit the note. So my other option is to find a way to work within my range and hopefully carry that song well enough to scrap it, or to not scrap it, and pull it off in a way that I still can get the song through, get the meaning through, get the feeling, and do the artist proud that originally did it. And Cyndi Lauper is such an amazing artist, and I hope I do her proud with this song. So we're going from a quote from A Wrinkle in Time to a song called Time After Time that is very, very important to me. Just gonna shift a little papers here because I actually wrote down notes because that's how important this all is to me. I got a little, it's funny, I was going to record yesterday and then I got a little inspired. So let me just tuck this right over here and then we'll get going. I did come out here to practice and my three cardinals were bopping around the apple trees over here. The female even came down, took a drink from my water fountain. And I was like, I better get out here and get recording while it's still quiet before the kids come home from school. And I think we're good. Slow, I fall behind. that felt good. That felt good to get that out. I've been playing that song for a long time, and I want to remind you that right now, I'm gonna move a little bit because my face is in the shadow here. I want to remind you that a lot of people are feeling really, really down right now, really helpless. Sometimes that is manifesting itself in some really just scary ways. If you find yourself feeling kind of not so great, take a breath, take a breather, go home. Just don't feel like you have to be out and about, you know, but also other people are feeling like you and understand that. Please feel free to reach out to whomever you think might be feeling like you and send them a text and say, hey, you know, I'm feeling really lonely, but I also don't feel like talking right now. That's okay. I've done that. I've been doing that through this with a lot of people. One in particular who helped me with what I'm hoping will be our next song. I was really struggling, and I hope I got her a little bit excited about what's coming next too. So, you know, give her something to work on, because I was feeling kind of lousy over the last week and a half, and this gave me something to be excited about and get me back in my headspace where I belong. So you're in Aiden's apple grove, and instantly the apples are getting ripe over there. And so we should, I don't know, in a couple weeks we should be able to start picking apples, like really picking them. We have actually picked one, we've tasted it, it is tart. But yeah, we actually, in our very front yard, we have some apples that will become applesauce or apple pie or possibly apple crisp. I'm really hoping for some apple crisp because I love some apple crisp. So this is 15 minutes and it's too long, and I love you guys, and I will see you next time, hopefully from the same place, and I hope that we have a few more sunny days here.